When working with revenue, there's one equation that's very helpful. Number times price equals revenue. Or N times P equals R. You also need to be aware that profit equals amount after expenses are paid. And to solve, we divide by what we want. In example 1, we see that a group of college students bought a couch for $80. So there were a number of students, each paying a price to get an $80 couch. However, 5 of them failed to pay their share, so the others had to each pay $8. So the number of students went down by 5, and the cost, or the price, went up by $8. But the couch still equaled $80. We want to know how many students were in the original group, or the number of students. So that's what we're going to divide by. When we do that, we now have P is equal to 80 over N. We're going to do a similar thing in the second equation. Notice that we have 2 binomials multiplied to each other, and so we're going to divide by the binomial that has the N in it. This gives us P plus 8 is equal to 80 divided by N minus 5. I'm going to leave these both the way they are and take this, which I know is equal to P, and substitute it into P for P in the second equation. This gives me 80 over N plus 8 is equal to 80 over N minus 5. From here I can find my LCD, which is N times N minus 5. And I'll multiply my LCD through to clear my fractions. Dividing out the common factors gives me 80 times N minus 5 plus 8 times N times N minus 5 equals 80N. Now I'll distribute to clear my parentheses. 80N minus 400 plus 8N squared minus 40N is equal to 80N. I see that I have an 80N on both sides of my equation, so I'm just going to subtract 80N from both sides. Makes the process a lot quicker. And then I will rewrite my terms in descending order of exponents. And there's my quadratic equation set equal to 0. I see right now that everything is divisible by 8. I get n squared minus 5n minus 50. Notice that if I divide both sides of my equation by 8, the 8 disappears, or technically divides out, and I'm left with n squared minus 5n minus 50 is equal to 0. When I factor this, I get n and minus 10 and plus 5. N minus 10 equals 0 and n plus 5 equals 0. So I get n is equal to 10, or n is equal to negative 5. When I substitute this back into my original equation, I see that n equals negative 5 would not work, because that's a negative number of students. So there were 10 students originally. In example 2, a merchant bought several pieces of silk for $70. So the number of pieces of silk for a certain price equals $70. He sold all but 2 of them, so n minus 2, at a profit of $4. His total profit was $18. So that means it's above and beyond the $70 that he already paid. So he's going to make, overall, $88. How many pieces did he originally purchase? So we want to know the number of pieces. So we're going to, again, divide by n. So P is equal to 70 divided by n. Once again, we're going to divide by the n binomial here. So we're going to get P plus 4 is equal to 88 divided by n minus 2. Substituting this in for P in the second equation, we now get 70 over n plus 4 is equal to 88 over n minus 2. Our LCD is n times n minus 2, and I'll multiply that through to each term in my equation. This divides with my denominators to clear my fractions, and I have 70 times n minus 2 plus 4n times n minus 2 equals 88n. Distributing, I get 70n minus 140 plus 4n squared minus 8n equals 88n. Subtracting 88n from both sides, this gives me 4n squared minus 26n minus 140 equals 0 in order of descending exponents. Dividing by 2 all the way through gives us 2n squared minus 13n minus 70 equals 0. My factors are 2n plus 7 times n minus 10 equals 0. So 2n plus 7 equals 0, and n minus 10 equals 0. So n is equal to negative 7 halves, or n is equal to 10. This is negative, won't work, so this is my answer.